Nobody here. I'm gonna see how much shit I can steal out of Nate Diaz's gym.
What are you doing?
What?
Fucking crackheads? Oh! Give me that part of that.
Middleweight champion, 6-0. Undefeated amateur. I fight middleweight, 185. I'll drop to 170 for UFC only. About like 95% finish ratio. I've only ever not finished one fight. Gonna come out there and either submit you or knock you out, knock you out, knock you out, knock you out.
Michael Sensi here at FightMike MMA. We're here at Gracie fighter Lodi with Nick Kohring. How you doing, man?
Doing pretty good. Just getting ready for my fight October 11th, main event. Global knockout too, so should be good.
Tell us a little bit about that. Does this guy calling you out, trying to say he's gonna beat you, pretty easy? What's the deal with this guy?
I don't know. He hasn't fought in forever. He's a dinosaur, so. I'm about to just make him not fight for another long 3-4 years. So, okay, the promoter hit me up and told me, this guy says, oh, it'll be an easy fight. I trained with him before, or whatever. I'm like, bro, I never trained with you in my life, you know? So, that's what it is. I'll see you on October 11th if you make it to the cage. I bet you'll fall off with an injury or something, though. But, like they all do, anyone who calls you out always backs out. So, we'll see how it goes. Anthony Garcia.
Ooh, man, this guy means business. I'm actually thinking about growing one of these beards, man. I'm liking yours. How long did it take you to grow that thing out?
3 to 4 weeks. I don't grow beards that fast.
Mine's gonna take me like 3 or 4 months. Tell us how long you've been training here with at Nate Diaz's Academy.
About 6 years, and I've been training about 2.5 years before then. So it's been about 8.5 years altogether now.
Who's your favorite fighter?
Well, besides Nate and Nick and Jake and Gil, probably Genki Sudo, or I like Joachim Hansen and Kazushi Sakuraba. A lot of the guys people forgot about or don't really watch too much, but that are exciting fighters. I don't like everyone being boring all the time, you know, doing the same things. You watch some Genki Sudo fights, you'll see some crazy shit. Spinning heel kicks and crazy submissions, crazy takedowns, crazy footlocks, you know. Good submissions, good knockouts.
This guy's obviously been following the game for a long time, mentioning the names, because you're Sakuraba, Boss Rutan, all those guys, man. You're following it back when it was called NHB like I was, right? So what do you think the difference is now, man? Now that it's MMA, there's all these rules. There's more of these athletes that are coming in opposed to, like, fighters, man. And I know
people are fighting to win now instead of fighting the fight, you know. They're trying to win on points. They're looking at it more like a, you know, like a sport instead of, like, going out there trying to finish people and hurt people. They're, you know, if you don't think you could outbox someone or out-grapple them, they're trying to figure stall tactics out, you know, hold you up against the cage, throw a few knees, you know, get a takedown at the end of the rounds and stay away and hit you with a few jabs instead of, you know, go out there and exchange some real techniques and on the ground they're standing up and pushing the pace, you know. So instead they try and do stall tactics. I think that's a lot more of the new game. Who's a better point fighter?
So can you show us one of your favorite techniques, like a jiu-jitsu technique or something like that?
Yeah, I can.
All right, yeah, we're gonna work a knee bar setup from half guard on top. So, here we go. All right, for MMA stuff, we get right here. A lot of times, I'm trying to work this. He's trying to keep me from hitting him or elbowing him. So he's blocking a lot up top. And then now, from right here, I wanna grab his jaw and push over here. He's probably gonna be wrapping my arm up or pushing that shit away or whatever. And now, from right here, get underhook on the leg, post, go up, over, sit, boom, and knee bar. Thumb right here, boom, 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 boom.
CrossFit style.
CrossFit style. Now I'm in half guard and I'm trying to pass. And this guy's locking my leg out right here. He's locking me up, trying to work that. And so from right here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch over my hip, grab the foot, come down, knee bar.
Do you want to give a shout out to any of your sponsors out there, or the people that support you, enable you to fight?
Yeah, Benford's Custom Cycles, the Memory Tag, Chavez, Ochoa Law Offices, TrueNutrition.com. Who else? CrossFit Demolition, Gracie Fighter Lodi, Nick and Nate Diaz, and Om Sellers, up in Napa Winery. And that's all I can think of right now. Oh, and Automotive USA, Robert Ballard, what's up?
Guy sounds like he has a lot of supporters, guys. He's 6-0. This guy comes to fight. Not a point guy. He's a real fighter. This is Fight Mike, and Kohring, and he's sagging out. What is your next fight?
My next fight is October 5th. I'll be fighting for IFC. I'm fighting against Victor Tubera out of Modesto.